In the game Ghost of Tsushima, there's a move called the Moon Master Cancel. It takes a lot of practice to get right. I even made a video about it. It takes a really specific combination of hitting triangle and circle in the right way. This summer, I was trying to learn both the Moon Master Cancel and more about circuit boards. So I had this genius, maybe dumb idea to see if I could create a Moon Master Cancel button on my PlayStation controller. The end result of that was this ridiculous looking thing. I have no idea what I'm doing, so this is all hacked together, but hey, it worked. So the general idea here is here's this little moon right there. That's the button. It's a capacitive button, so as you're holding it, is active. And the controller all still works. It's got this kind of janky thing going on in the back and has this wire running to an Arduino, which is a circuit board, like a really cheap, simple, kind of hobby circuit board that you can program. And through a bunch of magic here, as long as you're holding this button down, it does perform a Moon Master Cancel. So, thought it'd be kind of cool to just to kind of walk through how this worked and how I did it. And in order to get started with that, I thought it might be helpful to kind of show you how a controller kind of works. So to kind of see how a triangle and circle button actually works, we're gonna have to take this thing apart. All right, so here are the different pieces we have. This is the back of the controller. Right behind the back of this is the main circuit board of the controller. And then this kind of sits on top of that, which is the front of the controller. And if we take a look at what the buttons are, so for example, here's our triangle button. If we kind of look at what the triangle button is, the triangle button itself is just this little plastic piece like that. The button sits on this kind of flexible membrane, and when you push down on it, it's pushing the underside of this. There's this kind of almost like kind of metallic conductive surface. And what that is pushing against is on the other side of this, and it's pushing against this kind of film strip that's on this. I'm going to take it apart so you can see it better. Okay, so this is the conductive film that sits under all of the buttons. So underneath this thing, this is all going to fall out when I do that. There we go. Underneath this, you can see the conductive film is under there. And this is where the magic kind of happens. And so when you're pressing down on this, what you're really doing is pressing this conductive pad onto this conductive film. And if we look at what's happening underneath it, there's these two different forks that aren't connected. But when you press that button down, because the bottom of it is conductive, it bridges the circuit between these and allows current to run from one wire to the other. And if we follow those wires back here, they go to these little pads. And those pads correspond to, on the main circuit board of the controller, the main brains of the controller. You can see there's actually matching pads. And so this actually kind of when the controller is all put together, this is pushed up tightly against it. And you can see more or less the way this works is the circuit board is sending out a current from one of these holes, one of these kind of wire ports, or pads. I don't know the technical name for them because I have no idea what the fuck I'm doing here. But it's sending out a current here. And when you push that button down onto this film, bridges that connection and allows the current to flow from one wire to the other and show up here. And so the circuit board, all it's doing to see is triangle down is saying, is there a voltage showing up here or not? When you lift the button up, that circuit is broken and the voltage goes to zero. Let's put this kind of back together and I'll show you how that works. So in order to show this to you, I'm going to put this together in a weird way without some of the components so that it could still work, even though you can still with the whole thing opened up so you can see it. Probably not the greatest idea to have open circuits and everything, but you know, science. So we're gonna do this nice janky thing here to hold this nice and tight. So this is gonna be a working controller without all of the button pads and without the back side of this, but strangely it still works. All right, I got this extremely high-tech setup here to show the controller and the TV at the same time. So here's that, this is that kind of rubber tab that is behind the, you know, the button. You sit on top of that and push down on it. And it sits on the controller like that. And when you press down, it bridges that circuit and does a triangle attack. You can do the same thing with a wire. If you put a wire on one side of the fork and connect it to the other, it's the same thing. All right, so the next thing is, how do we actually use that information to make a Moonmaster cancel button? The way I was kind of thinking about this is, if you think about one of these button pads, like for example this triangle button here, I'm just going to draw a really simple diagram here. So imagine that's the pad, and there's a wire coming from the circuit board and a wire coming back from the circuit board, and there's voltage kind of wanting to go here, but it can't because it's not connected. But then as soon as you push the button down, the voltage is able to jump across here and is able to go over to the circuit board, and the circuit board is like, oh, triangle is pressed. The way I was kind of thinking about this is, if we can attach a wire to here and attach a wire to here and run this over to our Arduino, I know this is a beautiful representation of it, then this voltage, we can decide, we can have the Arduino decide when this voltage comes down this way. So even if this button isn't being pressed, we can still send a triangle signal. And this also allows, we're not interfering with this, so the triangle button can still work. All right, so how are we gonna get wires from these buttons down to the Arduino? Can't really use these kind of thick wires, because when you try to close up the controller, they're gonna get in the way, or they're gonna get in the way of the buttons being pressed. But what I found was this kind of cool stuff. Where are you? There we are. Found this kind of conductive double-sided tape. What's cool about this is it's super thin. It's like thin like this film. It conducts like electricity, and it's tape. So if you can peel it, stick it to stuff, and both sides are conductive. We can use this to kind of almost like create little wires off of these pads in a way that it won't interfere with this pressing down on it, because it's conductive on both sides and it's super thin, so we can kind of just run it out the sides of the controller. It'll just fit between the cracks of the controller. And so you can kind of cut this stuff up and kind of make wires. So you know, like you can go, this is not going to be precise. It does need to be really precise to get it on there and not interfere with stuff, but just to show you, you know, like you can go and grab onto one side of the fork and just kind of stick it down nice and tight there. And it will now have kind of a wire coming off of it, and you can still press down on it. And then you can kind of run this out of the cord. Run this out of the controller. And so if you kind of imagine one wire is connected to one side of the fork, and then again, this is not accurate, but just to show you the general idea, if you were able to get this wire to then connect to the other side of the fork, then going like this would be the same thing as bridging that connection. And the idea would be that you would then run these wires all the way out along a cord, you know, for example, all the way to the Arduino. I am now noticing that I'm getting a lot of stuff on here, so I'll just add a couple more things before we move all this out of the way here. I'm going to show you what we actually did here. Oh my god. Don't take this as an example for how to manage your stuff. All right, so if we look what I actually ended up using, let's get that out of the camera so I can pretend I know what I'm doing. So if you look at this controller, you can kind of see I ended up having the wires come out of here, and there's a couple different layers separated by scotch tape because I totally know what I'm doing, and this is flawless and not janky at all. Covered up behind all this, it kind of connects up to a bunch of wires that runs all the way over to the Arduino, and I wanted to have a nice long sturdy wire so that I could set the Arduino on a table or on the floor and be able to play comfortably without all this stuff being in the way. And then the wires go to the Arduino, and there's a lot going on here, so I thought I would try to simplify it here yet again with a little bit of a diagram. On the controller, we care about three buttons: triangle, circle, and the Moon Master button we added. Inside, on that conductive pad, there's a wire coming from triangle to the circuit board that when it has a voltage, the controller thinks triangle is down. Same for circle. Coming from the circuit board, there is a wire that goes to triangle and circle. They actually share this same wire. This is where the voltage goes to these buttons, and it can't pass to the return wires unless the button is down. So when you press circle, it allows it to run back along that return wire. Or if you press triangle, that voltage is allowed to return on the triangle return wire, and the controller sees that triangle is down. And these are the wires that we're going to hack into. So we attach one of our wires to the triangle return wire and to the circle return wire and also to the voltage wire. And those three wires run from the controller down to our Arduino. And we also have one wire running from our Moon Master button through that same cable. On the other end of the cable, we have those exact same four wires. One serves as an input to know when the Moon Master button is down. The circle and triangle buttons run to these cool little chips that allow you to really quickly open and close a circuit and kind of choose to connect those wires. It's almost as if you were holding each wire and could just kind of connect it and release it when you want, but it's not doing it physically, it's doing it through a transistor, so it's really fast. So the Arduino itself is more or less just getting one input, which is whether or not the button is down, and it has two outputs, which is like controlling whether the circle or triangle circuit it should be open or closed. The Arduino has a very, very simple program that I wrote, and it just runs in a loop really, really quickly. And each loop, it's basically trying to figure out whether or not triangle and circle should be opened or closed. And for this, I had to figure out the exact sequence of when triangle should be down and for how long, and then how much of a wait should be between the buttons and when they should all be down. And this sequence is programmed in there, and it's basically looking at how long has it been since it started the Moon Master button. So for example, if we see that the time that has elapsed is 200 milliseconds, it means we should still be holding that initial triangle button, which means we can send a signal to this triangle box, which will close the circuit, which will allow the voltage to run from the black wire back to the green return wire all the way through the cable, over to the controller, and back to the circuit board, and trick it into thinking that the triangle button is being pressed. If the loop sees we're in this part of the sequence, we know that we don't want any buttons down, so it will open up those circuits and make sure that no voltage is being returned. And if we're over at this part of the sequence, we actually want both triangle and circle to be down, so we'll send a signal to the little box to say, hey, close both of these circuits, and we'll allow that voltage to go all the way back to the controller and think both buttons are being pressed. And that's basically all it's doing. It's just running this in a loop over and over and over and over again.
So the wires make it look complicated, but that's basically all that's going on here.
All right, finally now we'll just see what it looks like to use.
Maybe the coolest part of using this is the fact that it does the fastest possible Moon Master cancel, because it is firing the exact perfect sequence every time. I think I'll probably do a separate video on what the exact timings of a Moonmaster cancel are. I will note that I don't actually use this when I'm playing. It was more of a proof of concept, just a fun challenge to be able to pull off. All right, hope you enjoyed it. Later.